Hey, math class. Okay, so now we're going to talk about dividing fractions. And if you liked multiplying fractions, they're very, very similar. In fact, we can't actually multiply a fraction by a fraction. There's a long explanation to that, which I won't go into. Just know that some guy came up with it, some old mathematician guy, and he's probably not alive anymore, so we just have to do what he has said. He's not around to, like, argue with. But it's very, very, like I said, similar to multiplication, the way that we get around this not being able to divide a fraction by a fraction thing. And what it is that we simply look at our fractions. I'm going to call this my first fraction. I'm going to call this one my second fraction. Any fraction that's in this second spot, so it's behind the dividing symbol, what that means, in order to solve this problem, I'm going to take that second one and I'm going to do what's called invert it. I'm going to flip it upside down. So instead of having it be 1 over 2, I'm going to make it 2 over 1. Okay? And again, it's always, always, always the second one. This guy, I'm going to keep, I'm going to write him exactly the same. Keep him exactly the same. And then once I've flipped this one, I'm going to change our division sign to a multiplication sign. And then we can solve this problem exactly like we've been solving multiplication problems in class. Pretty cool, I think. So that means that I can cross cancel, I can do anything, just like solving a regular multiplying fractions problem. Now, if you see here, I'm still writing my problem in the horizontal fashion so that I can see really clearly what it is I can cross cancel, okay? So for example, you know, 1 and 3, I can divide out a 1, but that's not going to do me any good. But 2 and 4, I can divide a 2 out of both of those. That's their common factor. So 2 divided by 2 is 1, 4 divided by 2 is 2, and now I'm going to multiply these new numbers that I've created. So 3 times 1 is 3, 2 times 1 is 2, okay? So I could say that 3/4 divided by 1/2 equals 3.5, okay? Now I have to ask myself my two questions, right? Is this a proper fraction? Well, no, it's not, right? My top number is larger than my bottom number. So I'm going to come over here and do a little math. I got to divide my bottom number into my top number. So 2 can go into 3 one time. 1 times 2 is 2, and I have, then when I subtract, I have 1 left over. So this whole thing right here is going to be 1.5. So I can come back here and write my answer as 1.5. So that was question 1. Question 2, is this reduced down as far as it can go? And it is. So 3/4 divided by 1/2 equals 1 1/2. And you might notice too that like multiplication, it's a little weird. These are tiny fractions, right? They're very small. But we end up with an answer that's larger. That's okay. It might feel weird for a while, but remember that fraction land is different than like whole number world. In whole number world, multiplication makes numbers bigger. Division makes the answer smaller. In fractions, it's sometimes the other way around. Multiplication makes your answer smaller, and division, you could end up with an answer that's bigger than either of the two fractions you started with. Let's look at another example. So here I have 1.5 divided by 1/8. So the first thing I'm going to do, my first step, is to flip my second one upside down. I'm going to rewrite my first one exactly the same as in the first problem up there, and I'm going to change my sign from division to multiplication. Now then, at this point, I can cross cancel. I can do anything that I want, just like if it was a multiplication problem. So what should I do? 2 and 8, do they have a common factor? They sure do. I'm going to divide 2 out of both of them. 2 divided by 2 is 1, 8 divided by 2 is 4. And then I'm going to multiply to find my answer. So 1 times 4 is 4. 1 times 1 is 1. And you see, I end up with an answer 4 over 1. Now, if you remember from multiplication, anytime I have a 1 underneath, that means that this guy is really a whole number. So that my answer is just going to be 4. So 1 half divided by 1 eighth actually equals 4. What happens if I have a whole number? Right here I have 3, and I want to divide it by 3 fourths, right? What if this guy right here is a whole number? Just like in multiplication, I'm going to draw a line, put a 1 under it, and that will turn it into a fraction. Okay? And then, this is my first fraction, this is my second one. The second one, I'm going to flip it, right? I'm going to exchange the places of the top and bottom number. I'm going to leave this guy exactly as he is, and I'm going to change my division sign to a multiplication sign. At this point, is there anything I can cross-cancel? Why, yes, there is. I can divide a 3 out of both of these guys. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 3 divided by 3 is 1. Oh, how funny. This one, what does it equal? 4 over 1 as well, right? It's the same answer as our last problem. That's funny right there. So, again, I get 1 times 4 is 4, 1 times 1 is 1. Any number over 1 is just a whole number, so I know that that's my answer. So what I could say is that 3, the whole number 3, divided by 3 fourths equals 4. Let's look at another example. So here I have a whole number, but it's in the second spot. Okay, that doesn't matter. I'm still going to draw a line, put a 1 under it, and then because it's in the second spot, I'm going to flip it. I'm going to invert it. I'm going to make it, instead of 6 over 1, I'm going to make it 1 over 6. My 8 ninths, I'm going to keep exactly the same, and my division sign, I'm going to turn into a multiplication sign. Is there anything at this point that I can cross-cancel? Hopefully you're beginning to see these cross-canceling things a lot quicker now. But yeah, the greatest common factor of 6 and 8 is 2. I can divide a 2 out of both of these. 8 divided by 2 is 4. 6 divided by 2 is 3. And now I'm going to multiply to get my new answers. Okay, 4 times 1 is 4. 9 times 3 is 27. Now, is this a proper fraction? I have to ask myself my two questions, right? And yes, it is. 4 is smaller than 27. Is it reduced down as far as it can go? Question 2. Ooh, and for this one, let me slide over here and list out my factors. There's 4. 27 is 1. 27, 3, and 9. I think that's all of the factors. And they have none in common, right? So that means I can come back over here and say, nope, this is reduced down as far as it can go. So 8 ninths divided by 6 equals 4/27.